When we choose silence, we choose to give up the reasons not to love, which are the reasons for going to war, or continuing war, or separating, or being a victim, or being right. In a moment of silence, in a moment of no thought, no mind, we choose to give those up. This is what my teacher invited me to. Just choose silence. Don't even choose love. Choose silence, and love is apparent. If we choose love, we already have an idea of what love is. But if you choose silence, that is the end of ideas. You are willing to have no idea, to see what is present when there is no idea, past, present, future. No idea of love, no idea of truth, no idea of you, no idea of me. Love is apparent. Gangaji, 2009. Lustily, I dipped my oars into the silent lake, and as I rose upon the stroke, my boat went heaving through the water like a swan. When, from behind that craggy steep, till then the horizon's bound, a huge peak, black and huge, as if with voluntary power instinct, upreared its head, I struck and struck again. And growing still in stature, the grim shape towered up between me and the stars. But after I had seen that spectacle, for many days my brain worked with a dim and undetermined sense of unknown modes of being. Or my thoughts, they're hung in darkness. Call it solitude or blank desertion. William Wordsworth, 1888.